Hey everyone, how's it going? In this tutorial, we'll create a cool poster design in Inkscape with the unique character and how to access it in Inkscape to create more variation to the text. Let's begin. Okay, first create a text with text tool, press T and type Xenophon 2 and scale it up by clicking the text and hold Ctrl Shift to scale it up. And for the second text, just going to duplicate this, press Ctrl D and scale it down. Press T, change the text. Scale it down a little again. Next, I'm going to type again, press T and type. Change the font to increase the text size by clicking text and hold Ctrl Shift to create a proportional scale. You can select the back object by pressing Ctrl Alt Click or Alt Click and move it to here and scale it down a little by holding Ctrl Shift. And now what we're going to do is using the glyphs in Inkscape. So this Golden Hills font come with the glyphs. So what I mean is, you can see right now, there is two variations of the T, the lowercase one and the uppercase. So how do we add the variation of the T using the PUA? Now I'm going to show you about the PUA in fonts, the private use areas in Linux or private use character on Windows. So this is the lowercase one and the capital one and this is the numeral, right? Let's see how it works with the sample text. You can see more variation for the letters. And this subnet, the PUA, the private use areas, encoded characters are highlighted. So in order to use these glyphs, let's open the character map with the PUA. So let me show you how to do it. Okay, let's open the character map. For Windows user, I put a link in the description how to access the glyphs in Inkscape. Let's find the font. So in this case is the Golden Hills. And head up to the PUA, the private use areas, and we see this is the character they highlighted in yellow. So let's sample, take this character and double click. It's invisible, but it's okay. Just click copy, press T to edit the text, press Ctrl V to paste. You can see the font not fitting with the textbook correctly, so fix that with the path and just object the path. Now with these glyphs, you can add more variation to the text. Alright, and add more text, so I'm just going to duplicate this. Press Ctrl D. Place it on here. Add some background with the single tool, click this icon. Make sure to turn on this enable snapping, the toggle snapping, this snap to the page border. So when you drag in, there is a tooltip and you can drag it down to the corner. Press F1 to activate the transform tool and press D to activate the Drupal tool and change the color to this color. Or you can input the color code to here. And let's change the text color. Next step, we're going to create the outstroke. So duplicate this text, press Ctrl D and make it combine by going to path, choose combine. And now we're going to create the outset or the outstroke by going to path, click this outset. So you see this shortcut, we're going to press this shortcut for a few times. So let me press 1, 2, 3, 4. Press D to activate the Drupal tool and change the color same as the background. Press F1 or you can click this icon and move it to the bottom. Click this icon to rest for a few times. Okay. You can send this text to the lower back. And do the same for the other text. So I'm going to duplicate this. Pretty nice. The last thing, we're going to add some light gray elements. Press B to activate the Bezier tool and hold Ctrl to create a straight line like this. And right click to release. And let's change the stroke color to this red by pressing D and hold Shift to set it to the stroke. Click this Edit Objects menu, or the shortcut is Shift Ctrl F. And let's change the stroke style to around 3 pixel or 9. Let's change this rectangle shape to the rounded one. Now we're going to create a clone with the clockwise rotation. Click the stroke and go to Object, choose Transform. And in Rotate tab, make it by 15 degrees. So to clone in clockwise rotation, you have to press Ctrl D to duplicate and hit apply. Press Ctrl D again and hit apply. Press Ctrl D and hit apply. Repeat the steps. I'm going to select this. Make the stroke become a path by going to Path, choose Stroke to Path. Then while in selected like this, make it unite in path, choose the union and send it to the bottom and click this icon to raise up. Now we're going to create an intersection to the circle, click the circle icon. And now I'm going to remove the snapping for a while and hold Ctrl Shift to create a proportional circle. Click the circle and the shape and go to path, choose the difference. Add some cut effect with Bezier tool, press B, and on here, select these two objects, the leg raise and this, and go to path, choose the difference, and do the same on here. Now I promise you the last thing to add more ray elements by duplicating this object, press Ctrl D and click until you see this rotate icon, then rotate it around here and click again. Now we're going to scale it down by pressing Ctrl Shift around here, click this icon to send it to the bottom and this to raise one step up. I hope you can learn how to access the glyphs in Inkscape to create more variation to the text and some light gray elements with the clone clockwise rotation. You can try some experiment with another quotes word or something by using any fonts. I'm Zakay from Zakay Design. Create something good today. Thanks for watching.